I've been waiting for an Avengers movie, both specifically about the Avengers and a continuity-driven superhero team-up movie more generally, for about as long as I can remember. So, about 28 years, give or take. And in a little under 2 weeks, I finally get to see one. Actually, that's not totally true. It's most of you who will have to wait almost 2 weeks to see the Avengers. I get to see the Avengers a couple of days from now, because things like that are my consolation prize for working on and within the internet. Ugh. Which means this will be the last time I can look at the broad overview of what the Avengers, both as a movie and an unprecedented multi-film movie production undertaking, means for the popular culture with an objectivity uncluttered by whether or not I liked the movie. Of course, some critics already have seen it, and thus far the reviews are trending overwhelmingly positive. According to some kind of Fandango poll, it's even the most anticipated movie of the entire summer. Yes, even ahead of the Batman movie. So it's almost a foregone conclusion that barring some unforeseen calamity, the Avengers is going to make a massive impact on the box office and on the immediate culture. And if so, it's going to be seen not only as a success in its own right, but a validation of the unique, never-before-attempted production scheme by Marvel Studios that brought us here in the first place. Continuity has long been the lifeblood of geek culture in the realms of comics, literature, and even television, but in film it was long considered too complicated to maintain. You had long-running series with internal mythology or the occasional leap back and forth between related media, but never anything as tightly unified as, to use the most relevant example, superhero comics, which exist in a publisher-contained universe and leap in and out of each other's stories like passers-by on a crowded street. This had been one of the main reasons why so many characters from such stories arrived on movie screens feeling more than a little watered down, forced to jettison or explain away some of their more offbeat conceits born of originating in sprawling genre-integrated worlds. But the Avengers could very well change all of that, by officially uniting four, so far, different movie franchises that have already been peeking over one another's fences. It could permanently brand the shared universe concept into audiences' heads as something commonplace and even expected of the genre, much the same way it is in comics. In a way, maybe it had to wait this long. The modern world of on-demand, mashed-up, mass multimedia, where release windows are shrinking and films, TV, books, music, etc. are able to exist simultaneously within the same instantaneous distribution systems, is a world where it's easy for one piece of entertainment to bleed into another that you might as well just start making it official. If Captain America and the Hulk are already in the same basic genre and next to one another in your iTunes folder, why shouldn't they also just be in the same movie? That in and of itself is an exciting prospect, as it opens up all manner of possibilities once thought largely unfilmable, though it also has its share of red flags. Right now, continuity in superhero movies is a fun little game and a way of rewarding those in the audience who thought to pay attention, which is how it used to be in comics. But from about the early 1990s onward, it became an overused, endlessly repeating crutch that wound up sucking all the oxygen, to say nothing of fun, out of the genre. The prospect of getting, say, a Secret Wars or a Crisis movie is kind of thrilling. The prospect of suffering through a Countdown or One More Day movie, not so much. Do I want Iron Man 3 to address how much Tony Stark's day-to-day life changes after he's spent the Avengers hanging out with Viking gods and fighting aliens? Yes. Do I want Incredible Hulk 2 to be devoted to some convoluted explanation for why Bruce Banner used to look like the guy from Fight Club, but now he looks like the guy from Just Like Heaven? No. On the other hand, I'm actually a bit more interested to see what kind of effect the potential mainstreaming of the shared fictional universe concept could have outside of this one genre. Like I said, this kind of storytelling feels tailor-made for the age of on-demand and Netflix, and since continuity first entered comics as a way to draw fans of one book into reading other books, one can only assume Hollywood would welcome the chance to turn a tangential connection to one movie into a selling point for another. Like, say you're making a romantic comedy that requires there to be, like, a cop in a supporting role for this or that story point. If you've also got a big cop movie in production, maybe have that same cop be the cop in the other movie. Presto! Now maybe people who like that character go to see both movies when they might have only seen one. Now granted, this could also easily be abused. I'd really rather not see every single generic stunt cast character from Expendables 2 get their own ongoing series, for example, but the possibilities are intriguing. Here's another one. If your studio decides to make a bunch of war movies, instead of having to come up with a different generic version of Al-Qaeda every time, just make up one and keep using it. See? Now you've got a series. Heck, you could even do crossovers, and not just the jokey ones like Freddy vs. Jason either, ones that actually make non-ironic sense. Hey, like, what if Mark Wahlberg's cop from The Departed went after Ben Affleck's crook from The Town? I mean, those two guys have to make a Boston crime movie together at some point, it might as well be that one. Oh, wait, I got it. Steven Spielberg is gonna do a new version of The Ten Commandments, did you hear that? Yeah, apparently he's gonna do that at some point. Well, think about this. What if, at the end, when the Israelites make the Ark, it's the same Ark from Raiders? Yeah, suddenly it's not just a Moses movie, it's a prequel to Indiana Jones. You could even cue up that John Williams opening the Ark music and everything. How awesome would that be, right? Right? Anybody? Just me? Fine. All right, my point is, however good or not good the Avengers turns out to be, it could very well be bigger than the sum of its parts. It might not just be a movie, it might be the future, for better or for worse. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.